I got some requests to share a current makeup look. I haven't done one of these videos in a long time. I used to do them on my old channel, The Busy Bee Buzz. And it's basically where I just talk you through the makeup that I've been really enjoying wearing lately. And I got a lot of questions to share the Tartlet palette. It's a matte Amazonian clay matte palette from Tarte, obviously. So this is what it looks like if you wanted to see. It was in my favorites last month. Or 2 months ago, I don't remember, but I've been wearing it a lot. And I thought I would just kind of talk you through my makeup, just do it as I do it. That's funny, just film it as I do it, I mean. And to show you. So I always start by sanitizing my hands, just making sure there's no oils on them. Moisturizers that I recently used, and I got out a cloth, a little baby wipe. I don't know why I called it a cloth. Now, as you can see, we got some oiliness here. So I'm going to grab my Basha, still not sure, pink peppermint blotting linens. These were, they're like, they come out every holiday season with this variety. They're green tea ones are some of my favorites. But these are nice too, and I just kind of take down the shine a little bit. I usually use about 3 or 4, just to make sure we're mattified. And I apologize about the lighting if it's not awesome. I'm like filming on my vanity to try to be, you know, just do what I do here. And it's not exactly like meant for filming because there's no natural light here and there's no, there's not really a place to put a lot of light. So do what I can. I've got my Dior Star foundation. I've been really liking this lately. You'll probably see this in my favorites next week. This is, I'm using shade 20. And I just do 4 pumps of that. I'm very, like, weird about my foundations. I like to wipe the nozzle off every time I use them. So I'm just going to apply this with my It Cosmetics. I think this is the LBD, like, little black dress brush, foundation brush. I'm not exactly sure if that's the exact name of it, but I will link what I can, if I can't fit it in my description box, because I just found out there's a limit, a character limit, I will put it on my blog post. You guys, links to all these products if you want to see them online. This is just such an easy foundation. I feel like it goes on really naturally. It's kind of a, I think it's more of a medium coverage. My skin's been okay lately. I started breaking out a little bit around my chin this week. Hormones, so much fun. And, but I really like this brush. I'm probably going to be showing this in my favorites too. So a couple of favorite spoilers here. And I just bring this just a little bit down my neck and just kind of blend that out. Voila, donezo. Okay, now normally I would put on, oh well, I'm not quite donezo. Normally I'd put on concealer at this point. I don't see a lot of places I need it. Normally I use the Makeup Forever Full Cover Concealer. I'm gonna skip it. I mean, I could put a little up here, but I just really don't care. I only use it when I have like a big wonkin' thing on there, you know, like, oh, that's a zit. No, I don't think I need it today. Now I let that set. And I don't put powder on until I work on the rest of my face makeup, because now I go to my eye makeup. So I have my NARS Pro Prime Smudge Proof Eyeshadow Base. And I just usually do one, oh, I guess I need a little more. One per eye there. That didn't make any sense, but you feel me. Or maybe you're like, I don't know, is she even speaking English? Nobody really knows, to be honest. I could be speaking a foreign language most of the time for all I know, because I make up words and stuff. Okay. And I like recently reorganized my vanity a little bit and still kind of acclimating to where everything is. This is the Bare Minerals 5-in-1 BB Advanced Performance Cream Eyeshadow in Blushing Pink, one of my all-time faves. Just a little sweep of that on each eye. If you saw my 5-minute makeup tutorial, that's where I got some requests to do this. I'll link that in here for you guys if you want to see me like stress out about putting makeup on, like totally stress. That's good. And then I'm going to use my Chella Ivory Lace Highlighter Pencil. I know my eyebrows are whack. I can't like, I need to do something about them, but I can't. It's so nerve-wracking to me to go like have somebody else do them. In my mid-20s, I had a great esthetician, I can never say that word, who did my eyebrows like perfectly, and but it was like it took a while for her to like convince me that I should let her do that, because I'm just like very protective of them. I don't want them to become like, you know, I'm just always afraid they're gonna do too much, like at a wax place, or I don't know, threading. I don't even understand how that works, but I know I should probably do something with them, but you know, whatever. I really, the bottom line is I just don't really care that much. So there it is. So now I'm starting in with the palette. So I start in with my inner eye and then I kind of move out and then I do the crease and highlighter stuff. So what I do is I just take a mix of these two top shades on the left, very light shades, Free Spirit and Caregiver. And I just kind of pat that in to the inner corner, like so. Yep, just to give it a little, the pink is a nice little highlight. Then I go over to Force of Nature. Oh, and I'm using a Sigma Medium Sweeper E54 brush, by the way. Love, love, love this brush. Actually, all the brushes that I'm going to be using today, they are my favorite everyday brushes. So I love, love, love all of them. So I'm just sweeping this part over the kind of the meat, middly, meaty part of my lid. And then I just go back with a little bit of that Free Spirit, and I always tap off because this is a little bit powdery, this palette. I think that's why some people just really don't like it, because it's like a little chalky in nature, but it just goes on so smoothly to the eyelid, so it's not really chalky once it hits the skin. Anyway, I just put that Free Spirit to just kind of blend the two together. Now I'm gonna go into Natural Beauty, which is this really pretty kind of plummy taupe shade. Or taupey plum, maybe that's a better description. And I'm just kind of lightly dabbing this in my outer corner. I mean, I like really natural makeup. You guys probably figured that out by now. But I also like playing and taking my time and having fun. Now I'm gonna grab my Sigma Shaper Crease E47 brush, and I'm going to go into Best Friend here, which is more of a true, deeper purple. And I really like this brush because it's just kind of pointy and small, and I have actually rather small eyelids, so this helps me kind of add definition to the outer corner without being like wah wah, like so much like pack that on, you know. It's, I really, like I said, I like light makeup, but I like playing, so I like to create these natural looks using, you know, fun colors and things. So now I blend at this point, and another Sigma. You'll notice a lot of my brushes are Sigma. I just really like them. This is Diffuse Crease E38, and I'm going to go into Wanderer down here. I had a brain fart for a second, which is a nice soft brown color, and I'm just going to very lightly work that in. I feel like it can get a little bit heavy-handed looking, because while these, like I said, while these shadows are a little bit on the powdery side, they're actually, I feel like they're quite pigmented. I still feel like I'm so shiny. I'm gonna have to see how the powder. Like having a real shiny day and my hair is like so flat. Well, whatever, can't have it all. Anyway, I don't know why I'm like rambling now. Okay, so we got that on. Now this to me is like the most important step for blending. I take the Sigma Soft Focus Shader E52. I go back into that Free Spirit color and I really get it in there. Still tap it off, and this is where I do my like kind of precision blending, even though it's a kind of a big brush, and I just sweep this kind of over the top edge of my crease to just kind of soften out that crease color I put in, and that creates a really nice soft look, kind of erases any harsh lines, and makes everything just blend really, really seamlessly. And that looks nice. And then I go into the bottom left of Supermom. This is just the lightest color in the palette. I just sweep that lightly under my brow. That wasn't so light, but just to give a little highlight. And that's basically it for eyeshadow. I'm going to come back to that palette in a second, though, because I'm going to move on to eyeliner now. But I use my eyeshadow in my eyeliner process. Now I gotta get super close to the mirror, so I apologize if I'm not in the, maybe I should do this. yeah, because I might not be in the frame. This is the Tarte MultiplEYE Liner. I don't know if they still make this. It's, you know, it's one of those pen liners. Oh gosh, I feel like, let's see if I stay in. I can't talk while I do this, so I'm just gonna like fast forward through this part. I really like this liner. It's a little bit loosey-goosey. It's that brush liner, so you have to have a little bit of control with it, but I really like it because I just use it to define very close to the lash line. Like, I realize it looks wonky as all heck, but I am going to straighten that out with the powder. So I go in with my MAC Fix Plus. I have my little MAC 208 brush, which is my favorite for doing this. And by the way, this little travel size of the MAC Fix Plus has lasted me like a year, which is awesome. So I'm gonna dip this slightly damp brush in my Fashionista color, which is this really pretty kind of like taupey black. It's almost like a gray, grayish black. And I am just going to have to stop talking now. Sorry, I had to pop out of frame for that. I feel like eyeliner is my most, the least reliant out of my makeup game. Like, I just feel like it's kind of the most hit or miss. But that's basically done with that palette. So we can move on. And at this point, I do my eye, like under my eyes. So I'm not doing any under eye products today. I'm going to use the NARS, Rue Bonaparte Larger Than Life Longer Eyeliner to line my lower waterline. Just open up those eyes a little bit. Wow, I feel like I am just really still very shiny. Okay. And voila, I'm not doing any under eye shadow. Now it's powder time. So I've got my Bare Minerals Bare Skin Perfecting Veil. I am in light to medium. I hit pan on this. It's always exciting, isn't it? And I have my Sigma Tapered Face F25 brush, my favorite powder brush. And I try not to go too crazy with the powder. I really just dip in 2 to 3 times. So I'm doing 3 today because I'm like looking so shiny. You can see this just, it mattifies, but without making you look flat. And I just feel like it's a really, really nice powder. And I just really wish my hair was cooperating, but you can't have it all. You know, you really can't. You can't straighten out our earrings, so I think I got makeup on my earrings. I usually don't put my jewelry on before I do my makeup for that reason. But, you know, I wanted to look nice for you guys. So now I move on to blush and bronzer. So I usually start with bronzer. I have my Too Faced Milk Chocolate Soleil bronzer. If you hear clickety-clackening and snarfing in the background, Winnie's got her face in her toy box and she's going to town. And this is the Chanel Precision, or no, the Chanel No. 2 Powder Contour Brush, which I love, favorite bronzer brush ever. And I don't go too crazy because I just feel like I don't really need it too much bronzer. And now she's blank. And then for blush, I love this Tartlet Amazonian Clay 12-Hour Brush and Celebrated. So pretty, and I just get so many comments on it, even though it's very natural looking. Love this brush. This is the It Cosmetics number 227 Flawless Blush Brush. Try saying that. Wow, that's harder than I thought it would be. Maybe it's just me. Could be. Anyway. You can get a little bit heavier with this because it is such a light blush. I still like can't say blush brush, whatever. And it just gives such a nice natural finish. It's just really pretty and somehow glowy, even though it's not, you know, it's totally matte, has no shimmer in it. And then I just blend out with my It Cosmetics Jumbo. I think this is the Jumbo Heavenly Powder Brush. I think that's what it's called, but like I said, I'll have all these things linked for you somewhere. If not below, it'll be on the blog post, which will be linked directly below. And I just make sure it kind of looks even. Yeah, I think that looks good. At this point, sometimes I add highlighter, but I don't really feel like it today, so I'm just gonna set my makeup with the Skindinavia Makeup Finishing Spray. I always make like such a weird face when I do that. And I let that dry while I clean my brushes. So I'm probably not gonna make you watch me clean my brushes, but basically I'll just show you what I do. I take a Kleenex tissue and I fold it in half like so. And this is MAC Brush Cleanser in a little spray bottle. and I spray it on. And I always do my face brushes first. I don't know why they have to go in an order, but they do. And I just, this is how I spot clean. I clean my brushes once a week, usually Sunday nights. It's when I deep clean my makeup brushes with my Sigma brush glove. Although I just got the brush mat and I'm excited to try that out. They like ran out of it, I bought it. But I just kind of swirl them around on the tissue. It just kind of takes the top layer off, so the brushes stay clean for the week. I don't wear makeup every day if I can help it. I only wear it when I'm filming or if I'm going out somewhere where I want to look like a human, you know. Oh, guess what? I didn't do my under eye concealer. I totally forgot that part. This is what happens when you are doing your makeup and you get distracted. Well, I think we can still do it. I'll just do it right now. So I have a two-step process. Normally I would do this before the powder and the face products, but whatever. I don't usually put what's it called? Powder right under my eyes, so I think it'll be okay. This is the First Aid Beauty Eye Duty Triple Remedy thing. And I just squeeze a little bit out. And it has this nice metal tip, which feels so good, especially if you're feeling a little warm. But to sit here and blend it out with just that takes about a million days, so give or take, you know. So I usually just go in with my ring fingers and do the rest. Like I said, I would normally do this before I put on my face powder and my face powder products. Because, yeah, we're going to have to blend that out again. But I got distracted because I was having so much fun talking to you guys. And I'm using this CoverGirl Ready Set Gorgeous Concealer. It's not my favorite under eye concealer, but I have it because I bought it. Because I love the foundation so much. So I thought, you know, why not? And this is my favorite under eye concealer blender. It's the Soft Blend Concealer F64 from Sigma. It's a beautiful brush. And I could have blended out my first aid product with that too. Anyway, now I can put those things away. And normally I set with this powder. This is the Benefit Powderflage. Sadly, they don't make this anymore. But the Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder is pretty much the same thing. So I'm just gonna have to, well, gee. Yeah, see, I already cleaned. I'm gonna look kind of funny today. Oops, kind of a fail there. Sorry about that. Anyway, continue cleaning the brushes until my face feels dry from the spray and all my brushes are clean. Okay, lastly, I do my brows and eyelashes and then lips. So I'm using this is the Hourglass Brow Sculpting Pencil Arch. I don't know what it's called. And again, I kind of have to get close for this, but I'll try to do it a little bit further away so you guys can see. I just kind of fill anything in that looks a little bit like sparse. I have pretty full eyebrows naturally, so I try not to go too crazy. Otherwise I look like, you know, what's one of the, what are they called? Harry, Curly, and Moe? You know, the guy with the like really, like the monobrow. Am I thinking of the right thing or am I like totally making something up in my mind? Might be making something up. I like this because it has a spoolie on the end and it's angled, so it's really easy. Because like I said, and we all know, brows are not my strong suit. But again, just don't really care too much. Like I care much more about like taking time on my eyeshadow and stuff. Which is funny because my eyebrows are more prominent. You think I would like take more time on that, but I don't. I feel like this is taking me so much longer than usual because I'm so chatty. I usually don't like talk when I do this, but anyway, I apologize. Rambly long video as usual. I've been loving this mascara. Probably another favorite spoiler. I've got my Chanel eye curlers here. I don't go too crazy with those. But this is the Pacifica Aquarian Gaze Water Resistant Long Lash Mineral Mascara. Love this so much. It's basically the only mascara I've worn this month, and I adore it. Oh, I left a big glob of brow gel. I didn't even tell you about the brow gel. That was the Rimmel brow gel. Sorry, I forgot to mention that. So I tend to be pretty delicate with my mascara because I just have very fine lashes and it really, really stands out when there's like too much product on them. And then I like to go back with a disposable spoolie. I use these for actually a few months, probably about 3 months before I dispose them. So box them lasts me a long time. I really like these rubber ones you can get from Sephora. They're a little more expensive, but like I said, they last a long time. They last about the life of a mascara, I think. And you can kind of wash them too because they're rubber. So I just comb through the lashes until it's kind of that natural look that I like. In keeping with the theme with the Tarte Celebrated palette, I'm using the Tarte Amazonian Butter Lipstick in Ethereal Pink, which was part of that special collection. It's a really nice stringy color. These lipsticks are so, hold on. They're so pigmented and, oh, I just touched it. And so creamy and bright and vibrant for being so, I don't know. They kind of remind me of the MAC Sheen Supreme formula. Pretty, right? Very bright and springy. Anyway, you guys, that was it. That was my whole look. I hope you guys enjoyed. I apologize, it's probably like a half an hour long video. This usually takes me about 15 to 20 minutes when I'm taking my time, but I'm not usually flapping my trap, like I said. I do have a giveaway for you. I didn't have the foresight to bring the products in this room, but I will inset a photo of them. I have the Tartlet palette, the Celebrated blush, and the Ethereal Pink lip butter, all as a giveaway prize, and I have two sets, so two of you will win, and it's just like all of my giveaways where you just pop on over to my blog. I will have that link below for the blog post specifically, and you can enter through the Rafflecopter widget there, and just follow the easy directions. It is open internationally. It will run for 1 week's time. There'll be two winners, and if you're under the age of 18, you just have to have parental permission to enter. That is all. I hope you guys enjoyed my super long-winded, chatty makeup application video. I'd love to hear what products you're using and loving right now. If you care to share, let me know, and I will see you guys real soon. Thanks for watching, guys. Take care. Bye.